Set up.
Welcome to another edition of the Roadrunner Review, the 30-minute magazine show that features Metro's Day sports and highlights from the past month. But on this show, we look back at the top moments of the past year as we recap the 2014-2015 Roadrunner season. I'm Oz Potter, and joining me is Davy Burke and Lennox Williams. Guys, are you ready to look back?
Yeah, what a wonderful year we had. It's going to be a fun look back.
It will be.
All them teams did an excellent job this past season.
And why don't we start off right here on our home floor with the men's basketball team. Head coach Derek Clark entered into his fifth season with the Red and Blue, and for the first time he's starting the campaign without Brandon Jefferson, the reigning National Player of the Year. But Coach Clark relied on his big two Aussie stars of Mitch McCarron and Nicholas Kay to continue the winning tradition here at Metro State. The dynamic duo led the Roadrunners to a 26-6 season, including an impressive 19-3 mark in the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference. The Roadrunners won the regular season championship on the last day of the season against always tough UC Colorado Springs. The squad earned its 17th NCAA tournament appearance since 1998, the most of any Division II school during that time. Another successful season in the books for the men's basketball team. And Lennox, why don't you tell us one of the top moments of the season where it came in the first round of the RMAC tournament?
It was definitely a top moment for the Roadrunners, but you know who had even a better day? Was Money Mitch McCarron. He got his first career triple-double, which hasn't happened since 1993. He had 11 points, 13 assists, along with 11 rebounds. And on that same day, he was named RMAC Player of the Year.
You know, it was great. It was came against our crosstown rivals in Colorado Christian. I mean, nothing better than to beat those guys on our home floor that first round
game.
We
know Mitch was happy, too, to get that triple-double against that team. Yeah. And, yeah, that winning RMAC Player of the Year, too, that same day, that had to be one of the biggest days of his life.
Hey, Metro's gone 3-for-3 in all RMAC Players of the Year
so far, the last three years.
But, Davey, another top moment was Eric Rare in the final season game. I mean, coming up big time.
Yeah, the Colorado Springs native against UCCS, a rivalry that's been really brewing. That game was back and forth, the atmosphere, unbelievable. Honored Joe McDermott at halftime, but him stepping up in the last seconds, only averaging 4.9 points per game, but hitting that big three-point shot, win the RMAC regular season title. He was mobbed after that game. That had to be one of the most unbelievable moments here in the history of Metro State.
I know I was nervous when he took that final shot. What about you two?
It was a good shot because first he pump faked, so he got a defender out of the way.
And it was so remind good. You, that was Derek White. Derek White out of the way. He juked him out of the gym.
Yeah, that was unbelievable. And I'm sure we weren't thinking Eric Rare was going to take the last shot, but he did, and he hit the biggest shot of his life.
Absolutely. Another story was that Aussie duel. I mean, Mitch McCarron and Nicholas Kay were unbelievable this season. Led the team in every category, scoring and everything. Kay led the team with 7 rebounds per game and 44 steals. And on the other hand, Mitch McCarron did it all in a new position, playing point guard, taking over for Brandon Jefferson. Unbelievable.
Yeah, I know when we talked to Mitch a couple months ago on the show, he was saying how at the beginning of the year he was nervous about being point guard. And then he said he loved doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it just kind of shows his versatility. And Nicholas Kay, too.
Those two were also named all RMAC teams, and Mitch McCarron was named to the second team All American, and Nicholas Kay was an honorable mention of All American. So while our men's basketball team relied on their 4 seniors to lead them this past season, the winners basketball team roster had only one senior and a bunch of underclassmen who were not afraid to take center stage in the bright lights of Division II. Fifth-year head coach Tanya Javi welcomed a very green group to downtown Denver, and they made their mark from the very first game of the season. Led by lone senior Denny Jacobs, the Roadrunners exceeded all expectation by keeping pace with the RMAC, hanging around all the top teams in the conference for most of the year. The squad would finish right at 500 for the season, and with 5 of their top 6 scorers coming back next year, something's brewing for the 2015-2016 season. Before the season even started, we looked at this roster, guys, and said, you know what? Rebuilding. And no one likes that word, do they?
Yeah, no, that was the theme of the year, was all the youth movement, all the underclassmen. They had 7 freshmen, 4 sophomores, and just 1 senior in Denny Jacobs. But, I mean, every game we saw a different freshman step up, whether it was Ordor, whether it was Stepanovich, whether it was Harnigan, they all had someone step up. And this year, or this team, they're going far, I think, next year. I mean, They went 13-13, but that doesn't really dictate the job that both Coach Jave and her staff did with this great young team.
I mean, Coach Jave is a great leader for this team.
All the rest of the teams, they had upperclassmen that was playing good, and the Roadrunners came to play every night, competing against the best of them that RMAC got to offer.
Yeah, they had a different freshman step up every night, whether it was Stepanovich, Bordorf, Hartnigan, and even Denny Jacobs, a senior, Janae Payne. This team had a lot of different players step up, and this team has a bright future ahead.
Well, how about Georgia Ordorf, named all our conference player, or freshman of the year, excuse me, and she's had some phenomenal games. She scored a career-high 21 points against crosstown rival Regis. I remember that night always. It's going to be great.
Yeah, she's going to really be the key for this team. I think she's going to be the star of this team, and she's versatile. She does a great job inside. She shoots well. So that's another sign that this Australian pipeline, too, it's not just the men, it's also the women.
And I remind you, she had 12 games scoring double-digit points.
Wow.
So look out.
Yeah, she's going to be a special player for Metro State going forward.
I'm now one of her players that we didn't mention was Anna Stepanovich. Mm-hmm. Actually, she had an impressive showing in her freshman campaign and also against Colorado Christian University. I mean, that was a tough game. With Colorado Christian, they had, as I was saying, they have mainly upperclassmen on their team. But in the first half of that game, she put up six points, excuse me. But in the second half, she erupted for 14 big points. And for her 20 points and 14 rebounds, the team showered her with our shaving cream. I know we was all at the game.
Both Coach Jave and Coach Clark will be back in their 2015-2016 season, and we're excited to see what they bring to the table in year six. We're just getting started here on the Roadrunner Review. We opened up the Regency Athletic Complex this past year, and boy, did all the teams enjoy that home cooking. Come on back as we recap the spring sports as both our softball and baseball team looking to christen the new digs with an RMAC championship.
You want family-friendly sporting events.
Sporting events where you can be comfortable.
And entertained in a positive environment. Watching great individuals and teams compete.
With commitment, effort, and good sportsmanship. That's what the Division II Game Environment Initiative is about.
Be a part of the excitement and find out why. These student-athletes say with pride,
I chose
Division II.
Thanks for coming back. We're still here reflecting on the top Roadrunner moments from the 2014-2015 season. While our women's basketball team had no expectation heading into their season, our softball team was picked to win the conference with second-year coach Annie Vendwetsinger running the show. Sophomore hurler Cassidy Smith was also tabbed the preseason pitcher of the year, and the squad was not going to sneak up on anyone this year. Smith had another fantastic campaign, but it was the amazing play of freshman pitcher Kenzie Maddie who gave the Roadrunners a 1-2 punch in the circle. The team dominated the competition to a 44-16 overall record and 28-6 in the RMAC. The likes of Mary Towner, Susie Owry, and Serena Espinoza led the Red and Blue to a regular season championship, to the RMAC tournament championship game, and a nice run in the NCAA tournament. Lennox, we talked about Cassidy Smith a little bit, but you know what? She shined when the whole RMAC was on the field and looking at her.
The sophomore pitcher, she was superb against New Mexico Islands. The Roadrunner scored 5 runs. She allowed none. She had a no-hitter. The only thing she allowed was 1 walk. But she had an impressive season. She went 19-7. She had 17 complete games with an ERA of 2.94. Whoa, she's a great pitcher.
Another thing was when they went to San Antonio for the NCAA game in the second round and beaten St. Mary's. Mm-hmm. I mean, Kenzie Maddie had an awesome performance. For a freshman to step up under those lights in the NCAA tournament was amazing. She went 7 innings, allowed 4 hits and 5 runs, and then 2 strikeouts.
I know with Coach Wetsinger, she had an excellent second season. Dave, I know you mic'd her up, and she's very animative, and you see that all plays in with the type of teams, the type of character she got on her team.
Oh yeah, she's certainly a character. She's a fun coach to talk to, and Yeah, coming into her second year, last year she led a turnaround that no one was expecting. But this year with high expectations, going 44-16, she wins the RMAC Coach of the Year Award, certainly deservingly so. They win the RMAC regular season title. They go runners-up in the RMAC tournament. She brought in a great young course, Serena Espinoza, Lonnie Redmond, Cassidy Smith. And we're going to see what she does in this recruiting class, but I'm sure to me nothing short of another talented batch.
Staying with our spring sports, let's recap the baseball team as they had an excellent season on their brand new turf field at the Regency Athletic Complex. Head coach Jared Otis enters his fourth season in downtown Denver, and it was all finally coming together for the boys this summer. Daryl Baca, Trent Maloney, Chris Locke, and the rest of the squad led the Roadrunners to a third place finish in the RMAC. After finishing with a 21-14 conference mark, the team sported a 9-game winning streak and a 17-game home winning streak during this past season. How much fun was it to see these guys perform on their new field? I mean, it was incredible. And you know what? We had many, many, many walk-offs in this season. That was incredible to watch.
Yeah, that was my favorite moment, I think. All the walk-offs. I mean, I like to call the team the Fighting Odies. They had all the walk-off wins, all the comeback wins, whether it was Trent Maloney, Danny Miller, Daryl Baca with that huge blast. This team would always fight back. They had that never-say-die attitude. And that's really what this team was all about, was the comeback wins, and they showed a lot of heart.
Absolutely. I mean, another thing was when the RMAC tournament time, and they beat number 2 Mesa in the, you know, they had to come back. They fought their way back from last season, not getting into the RMAC tournament. This season coming out third, they had a hard road to the championship. They beat Colorado State Pueblo 8-0. And remind you, a great performance by one of their senior, Mitch Gibbons. He went 6-for-17 in the RMAC tournament with 5 RBIs. And by the way, he had 2 amazing catches.
Yeah, what a bat and what a glove. If this was Major League Baseball, he'd definitely be a gold glover. But his bat, too, was always clutch.
Yep.
He did a great job at the top of the order. And he's going to be missed, but I'm sure this team's going to find a way to fill his void.
Lennox, what about the stellar performance of the freshmen, the young talents, the young guns stepping up?
It was so great to see those young fellas stepping up, especially freshman sensational Trent Maloney. He averaged a 323 with 4 home runs, and that's his second on the team. And he also is second in doubles and second in slugging percentage also, too. And our next phenom is Julian Garcia. He came out, did an excellent job in his first year campaign.
How lucky we are to see the young guns of Garcia and Maloney from baseball and Espinoza and Smith from softball in the next couple of years. The rest of the conference better watch out. Still more to come on the show. It's no secret that our women's soccer team is one of the premier squads in all the country. But who would have thought that our men's team would reach as high as number 8 in the top 25 rankings? We'll show you how they did next on the Roadrunner Review.
Are you a college student that needs a place to live? Are you still living with your parents and want your own space? The Regency Student Housing is perfect for you. The community offers many amenities such as a fitness center, 2 basketball courts, big screen amphitheater, all-you-can-eat dining hall, bowling alley, arcade, free parking, and a shuttle to and from the Auraria campus. For more information, please call 303-477-1950 or visit our website at regencystudenthousing.com.
Some students come to Metropolitan State University of Denver to find their future. Others look to sharpen their current skills. In the case of David Thibodeau, it was both. Our faculty helped fuel his entrepreneurial spirit while encouraging him to pursue his personal passions. These 2 talents came together in Ska Brewing Company, which he co-founded in 1998 in Durango and is considered one of the top up-and-coming Colorado companies.
Welcome back to the Roadrunner Review. I'm Miles Potter here with Lennox Williams and Davy Burke, and we're still wrapping up the 2014-2015 season for the Roadrunners. We now head to the pitch and look at our men's and women's soccer squads. The women's soccer team put together a fantastic season under 7th-year head coach Adrian Peets, led by the player of the year in the RMAC, Carissa Price. The team lost just twice all season long while going unbeaten in conference play. The 13th straight trip to the NCAA tournament is the current longest active streak in all Division II. A lot of great moments stood out, guys, but the one that jumped out was Carissa Price's hat trick versus Regis.
Carissa Price put the women's soccer team on her back to face against their cross-town rival, Regis University, and she produced her 3rd career hat trick. She had a 1 goal in the first half, 5 minutes into the second half, she notched her second goal. And then from a corner kick from Abby Roth, she had her third goal. But she wasn't done yet. She wasn't done right there. She also had it an assist. Yep. Man, that girl can play.
Absolutely. I mean, watching that game at home, we were just opening this field up. I mean, it was a great performance by her, making memories.
It really was, and that's kind of the performance that really solidified Chris Price as the RMAC Player of the Year. I mean, looking at her stats, she had 10 goals, 5 game winners, 23 points. She led the team in all those categories, and just her career at Metro was unbelievable. 42 career goals, 14 game winners. Her freshman year was injury derailed, but after that freshman year, I mean, she led this team in almost every category, every single year. Top player in all the RMAC. But her Metro career is not done. She's going to come back as an assistant, so we're going to still see her on campus.
It seems like you can just go all day with those stats, Davey. Another person that shined was Naomi Polanco. Against that same team in Regis, she had 2 goals and 1 assist in the second-round game of the RMAC postseason.
Yeah, it was good to see someone else step up other than Chris Price, but Naomi Polanco, another solid player for the Roadrunners. She had a great season as well. And it was good to see that other than Chris Price, other players could step up and
new. Well, you know, she was into the season. We were saying that she's going to be the X factor mm-hmm. of this team. She is going to really come off the bench, provide a spark that they need. But you know what? She had their opportunities, and she absolutely shined during
it.
One of the other storylines we didn't mention was true freshman goalkeeper Brianna Flores, who came in for the injured Sammy McCleary in the very first game of the season. She would go on to win 14 games and make huge penalty kick saves in the regular season and in the postseason. What a great season for Flores.
Yeah, Flores, the true freshman, stepping up. Bad injury to McCleary, which is a tough situation, but she stepped up and she was a wall. Nothing got past her.
Absolutely.
And the backline was impressive, which allowed her to be a good goalkeeper. Didn't allow too much shot to come in, and man, she did a great job.
Now let's switch to our men's soccer team, who reached some incredible heights in 2014. Ken Parson entered his 11th season with the Roadrunners and led the group to win their first 6 games of the season, which included an upset over 6th-ranked Regis University at home that propelled the team all the way up to number 8 in the top 25 rankings. All-region player Danny Arubula, Josh Belfridge, and Dustin Burke carried the team to the RMAC playoffs, and all three will be back next season. A couple of notes from both of our soccer team. Head coach Adrian Pietz is currently pregnant with her first child, and we want to wish her and her husband Mike a big congratulations. But have no fear, Coach Pietz will still be on the sidelines for the 2015 campaign. And to the other side of the ball, Coach Ken Parson is leaving MSU Denver to become the assistant athletic director at Cal State East Bay. He will join Joe McDermott, who was the former athletic director here at MSU Denver for many years. Stay tuned at GoMetroState.com as we will have the final interview with Coach Parsons. We're coming right back here on the Roadrunner Review.
And the celebration is on for Mike Dunlap.
The Skyhawks celebrate a second national title in program history. And the winner of the 2006 Harlan Hill Trophy as Division II College Football Player of the Year is Danny Woodhead from Shadron State.
ASU! ASU! ASU!
So glad you could rejoin us here on the Rary Event Center, the home floor of our men's and women's basketball team and our volleyball team. Let's head outside to recap a few of our outdoor sports now. We'll start with our women's golf team, who blew the doors open in year 2 of the program. Led by head coach Ben Porty, the squad would win their first tournament in Lakewood, shooting a school record of 311 and 304 on each day, taking first place. The Roadrunners then took the conference by surprise, winning the RMAC Tournament Championship, breaking an RMAC record for lowest round and lowest tournament score. Cha-Cha Wilhoit and Natalie Gallagher finished in a tie for third place, finishing 3 over at 147. It was a great season for the second year program and Coach Porty, who has a lot of these girls coming back for next season.
Brianna Hemming leads our track wrap up. The senior had another fantastic season, which included a 12th place finish in the 1500 meters in the NCAA championships in the outdoor season. She would be named second team All-America for her standout performance. Soon-to-be husband Michael Warburton also earned second team All-America for crossing the line in the 10th spot in the 1500 meters. Freshman Robert Carlson became the first men's track athlete in program history to post a provisional time in a jumping event. He broke the school record with a 7.23 meter jump in the long jump event. In the indoor season, 6 Roadrunners competed at nationals. Hemming again shined, finishing 8th in the mile, earning All-America honors. Carlson competed in the long jump, and along with the distance medley relay team of Ryan Boucher, Nick Cadillac, and Brandon Kroggy.
The cross-country teams once again continue to improve a nation's most difficult conference. The women's team finished 4th in the Central Regional Championship, qualified for the NCAA meet. The men just missed out on a big dance by one spot, finishing 7th at the regionals. At the NCAA Championship, the women's finished 23rd overall with a team score of 50 points. Victoria Alcala was the top roadrunners to finish, followed by Brianna Hemmings, Jamila Rashid, Ivana Ramirez, and Ariana Horton.
Josh Grades headlined the tennis team all season long. The sophomore finished the year ranked 44th in Division II ITA single ratings. Grades went 3-1 in number one singles and 3-1 in number two doubles and finished the season on a 10-match winning streak. Calum Hayes and Courtney Wright earned top honors after the RMAC named them the freshman of the year in the conference. Wright, Grays, Hayes, Nick Baker, and John Qualls all earned all-conference honors. We're coming right back with our volleyball recap and the top plays from the entire 2014-2015 season. You don't want to miss that.
Getting down to crunch time here on the Roadrunner View, and we still have plenty to get through. Basketball, baseball, softball, everything's coming up.
Softball in the RMAC Championship. Aubrey Mall had a great performance.
We got to get someone else in here. He's got to have ice in his veins to get through this highlight. BJ, you're in.
Let's go. Yeah, I mean, softball's had an amazing year so far. I mean, they have Aubrey Myles, the starting pitcher. I mean, they have
Clutch.
I mean, they got a lot of great hitters. I mean, so I think they're going to make a great run this year.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to make a wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
It's the final segment ever for Davy and I as we move on to the real world after this show. But before we all go, let's recap the 2014 volleyball season. The longest tenure head coach here at Metro State is Debbie Hendricks, and she is finishing up her 15th season here in the Mile High City. She led the program to a 23-7 overall record and a 15-3 mark in the RMAC. The runners started the season 21-3, which was the best start to a season since 1993. They sported a 9-game winning streak during the season and finished 3rd in the conference standings. Lauren Quijano carried the team on her shoulders and would be named AVCA Second Team All-American. MSU would punch their ticket to the big dance for the 15th straight season, the 4th longest active streak in Division II. Great job by Coach Hendricks and her squad. Now it's time for the top 5 plays from the entire 2014-2015 season, and they are brought to you by, as always, the Regency. To start things off in play number 5, we head to one of the biggest games of the year for our women's soccer team. 15th ranked Colorado School of Mines came to downtown Denver unbeaten, and with just one loss on Metro's record, the game would decide who hosted the RMAC tournament. This game headed into overtime. Brianna Flores clears the ball, but right to the Ordiggers. Deirdre Johnson looks to make Flores pay. She is tripped up in the box, and it's penalty kick time. All-conference midfielder Rachel Turner fires, but Flores, who is in true fresh, makes an incredible diving stop to keep the game scoreless. But the game would finish in a scoreless tie. That's big thanks to Flores, who came up big for the red and blue that night.
We'll stay with women's soccer in play number 4, and it was the RMAX Player of the Year who showcased her talents in a big way. Carissa Price welcomed in the Rangers from Regis University and gave them a night to remember, scoring 3 times and assisting on another goal to give her team the 4-0 win. She used her noggin on 2 of the goals, but her most impressive netter may have been her second goal when she beat multiple Rangers defenders to find the spot. She then rips the shot just underneath the crossbar where the goalkeeper has no chance. It was a big day for the senior striker who would go on to score 42 career goals here at Metro.
From one RMAC Player of the Year to another, we feature Mitch McCarron in play number 3. The senior Aussie had a field day against Colorado Christian in the first round of the RMAC tournament. McCarron would score 11 points, grab 11 rebounds, and dished out 13 assists to record the team's first triple-double in 22 years. An impressive feat indeed, but not as impressive as this.
Left to go, and stolen away by Eric Rayer. He's got Mitch McCarron, he'll give it up. Throwing it down over top of Shields. That was incredible, and a foul as well.
McCarron's dunk made it to ESPN, and we are open to see more of McCarron on the big network in his professional career.
Time to go dancing in the NCAA tournament, and our softball team took on crosstown rival Regis in the first round. The Rangers defeated Metro State in the RMAC championship game, so revenge was definitely in the cards. It's a 1-1 game heading into the bottom of the seventh, and true freshman Serena Espinoza is at the plate. Lonnie Redmond is at second. 1-1 pitch to Espinoza, and she sends it over the head of the left fielder, and Redmond easily scores, moving the Roadrunners to the 2-1 win and the winner's bracket of the regional tournament. Espinoza had a great tournament and will be back to lead Van Wetsinga's squad in 2016.
And the top play of the past year comes from the regular season finale of our men's basketball team. The highly vaunted UC Colorado Springs squad came into town, and the winner would host the RMAC Tournament Championship. All-conference guard Derek White connected on a jumper to put his team up by one with just 17 seconds to go. We'll let Davy Burke tell the rest of the story.
Inside to Kay. Over to Rayer, puts it up, and it goes! 1 second to go, and Eric Rayer with the biggest shot of his life.
A big-time shot from the junior to lead his squad to the 73-72 win. Those were the top plays of the 2014-2015 season, and as always, they're brought to you by the Regency. What a fantastic season from all the athletes, coaches this past year. And for Davy and I, it's our final show here at the Roadrunner Review. Davy, tell us about your time here at MSBN.
It's hard to believe it's over, but I mean, MSBN's meant so much to me. Eric Lansing, Kermit, Lennox, you, even Peter Aragon, Kevin Hall. Guys have meant so much to me. I mean, I got a chance to really build myself. It's great to get the experience I had, try to do this for a living. And it's just been unbelievable. I can't repay anyone for all the time I had.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I got to thank Eric and Peter and Kevin also. I mean, those guys were a big influence on my decision to stay here with the MSBN. And, you know, it was a huge opportunity. So big thanks to them.
And we gave y'all guys some memory. Hopefully you guys all like the plaque. And that is hard work and dedication from top to bottom on both plaques.
Oh, yeah. It's going right up on my wall, yeah. But we're excited to see what you do. Kermit Ball as well. We got Sean Tafoya also. And then can't forget John Madden, Anthony Rodriguez. You guys are going to take the show to the next level as well.
Well, you guys are leaving it in good hands, and hopefully we could exceed expectation, because I know you guys want us to do a good job, and we want us to take it to a different universe and see how it goes. But at the same time, we've got to thank all the past, MSBNers.
Well, I'm sure I speak for Davy as well. We want to thank everyone here at Metro State, the administrative staff, the coaches, the players, the Office of Student Media, the Media Center, and you, the viewers. Until next time, you won't see us until September as we preview the fall sports season.
That's right, Myles. We'll preview that new year coming in the fall. But for Lennox Williams, Myles Potter, Kermit Ball, Eric Lansing, and everyone at MSPN, we had a great season. We hope you guys did as well. Have a nice summer, and we'll see you next fall.